Ho, 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 everybody. Ham Radio Now, episode 283, A Ham's Night Before Christmas, the live edition. I wrote A Ham's Night Before Christmas 20 years ago, 1996. The first two lines had been floating through my head for, I don't know, probably years. 'Twas the night before Christmas and all through 2 meters, not a signal was keying up any repeaters. That's as far as I went. In 1996, I decided to try to flesh out the rest of the poem. Didn't know whether I'd be able to do it or not, but I thought I'd give it a try. I didn't have a copy of it, so a friend, Pat Fix, KE4FCJ, wrote it out longhand. And so now I had something to compare to. And it pretty much flowed. It was really easier than I thought. And a lot of people have done versions of A Night Before Christmas. 'Twas the Night Before Christmas. There's something out there for just about every special interest in the world. Dozens, maybe hundreds of versions out there. Most of them are pretty bad, pretty tortured in either rhymes or trying to come up with words or get the meter right. It's not pretty. So I was pretty happy, and my goal was to make everything work pretty well. Now, I stayed somewhat true to the original for the first couple stanzas, and then I kind of drifted off. But I kept the meter right, I kept the rhymes relatively untortured, and I was pretty happy with the result. Jeff AC4ZO helped me fine-tune a few spots that I was having trouble with. So, the help of Pat Fix and Jeff Wittick, and we got the result. Oh, by the way, if all you want to do is play the original, it's still on YouTube. You can still find it. I'll put a link here in the description. Take you back to the original without all this blah, blah, blah at the beginning of it. So in 1996, I wasn't doing any YouTube. I wasn't doing any ham radio video. That was still almost a decade away. And I wrote the poem. It appeared in our radio club's newsletter. Then everyone said, well, can you do it live at the club meeting in December? It was the annual Christmas party. So I did it at the Raleigh Amateur Radio Society live. And then a few other radio clubs said, could you do it at our radio club? So I did it live at a few other radio clubs, including all the way down in Wilmington, which is a couple hours drive away. The fame spread. it ended up online. I don't know if it ended up online the first year or not. My memory of the internet from the mid-90s is a little bit weak. So it might not have been online right away. But by the time it got online, it got copied a lot. Some of the copies even gave me credit. A lot of them didn't. Like eham and qrz.com, the famous places. And I don't remember exactly what year it was. I think it was like 2003 or so. I decided to record an audio version. And I did that at Soundtracks, the studio that I record at. And that's the audio that you've been hearing over the past few years. And then a few years ago, a friend of mine, another freelancer, Don Merckx, a WA3AYR, I think is Don's call, he did a guitar medley of Christmas songs. And he gave that on CD to all of us at Soundtracks and a bunch of other friends as a Christmas present. And I had been looking for a soundtrack for the to accompany the poem, the verbal rendition of the poem. And that sounded like it was going to be perfect. And that's the music that you've been hearing for a while. Only took a little bit of editing to make it time out right. And then I thought, I'm a television guy, and now I'm doing the television thing. I should do a video version. But where was I going to get the pictures? Maybe I could find someone who'd be willing to draw some cartoons. Didn't know anybody who had that talent, and it was going to be a lot. I realized it would be a lot of pictures. Doing anything live action, out of the question, way too much work, too many people. This had to be pretty much a free thing. And then I realized that QST Magazine has run a Christmas cover pretty much since they started the magazine in their December issue. Something Christmas-oriented, some years more than others. And I thought, well, maybe that could give me at least some wallpaper, if not necessarily a story to go with it. So I asked permission from ARRL, and they granted it, said, sure, you use anything you want. So I grabbed all the covers that had something reasonable to do with Christmas, and I was way, way short, not nearly enough pictures to cover what I wanted to do, even as wallpaper. And I also realized that maybe I could do a little bit better than wallpaper. Maybe I could do almost a story, but I needed more pictures. And as I was looking through those QSTs, I realized a lot of the advertising also had a Christmas theme, a lot of Santa Clauses and you know, bows and ribbons and wreaths and Christmas stuff. And so I took a lot of the ads out and started putting things together. I asked for permission to use the images from everybody who was still in business, and everybody said yes. So all of the images that you're about to see have been used by permission. If they came out of QST, or if they came, or the ads that were in QST, from permission from the advertisers. So everything is very much on the up and up. Was able to secure permission for everything. And I'm very happy with the way it turned out. It is not a perfect story, but I think it's even better than a perfect story because of the way the images match the stanzas, the verses in the poem. They work better than I ever had a right to expect them to work. Okay, so again, you can go look at the original if you want to see that. You can download the audio. You can I'll get it back on the website, and you can copy it. You can do anything you want with it. All this stuff is available for your use, as well as just sitting there and watching it. You put it on your website, put it in your club newsletter. Don't have to ask me. Just go ahead and do it. So here on the 20th anniversary of originally writing it and performing it live, I thought, well, let me mix myself in with the images and do it live for you and give you a live version of A Ham's Night Before Christmas. 'Twas the night before Christmas, and all through 2 meters. Not a signal was keying up any repeaters. The antennas reached up from the tower quite high to catch those weak signals that bounced from the sky. The children, technicians, took their HTs to bed and dreamed of the day they'd be extras instead. Mom put on her headphones, I plugged in the key, and we tuned 40 meters for that rare ZK3. When the meter was pegged by a signal with power, it smoked a small diode, and I swear it shook the tower. Mom yanked off her phones and with all she could muster, logged a spot of that signal on the DX packet cluster. Well, I ran to the window and peered up at the sky to see what could generate RF that high. It was way in the distance, but the moon made it gleam. A flying sleigh with an 8-element beam. And a little old driver who looked kinda mean, so I thought for a moment that it might be Wayne Green. But no, it was Santa, the Santa of Hams, on a mission this Christmas to clean up the bands. He circled the tower, then stopped in his track, and he slid down the coax right into the shack. While Mom and I hid behind stacks of CQ, this Santa of Hamming knew just what to do. He cleared off the shack desk of paper and parts and filled out all my late QSLs for a start. He ran copper braid, took a steel rod, and pounded it into the earth till the station was grounded. He tightened loose fittings, resoldered connections, cranked down modulation, installed lightning protection. He neutralized tubes in my linear amp. Never worked right before, now works like a champ. A new low-pass filter cleaned up the TV. He corrected the settings in my TNC. He repaired the computer that wouldn't compute, and he backed up the hard drive and got it to boot. And he reached really deep in the bag that he brought. And he pulled out a big box, a new rig, I thought, a new Kenwood, an ICOM, a Yaesu for me, an Alacraft, Tentec, or Flex, could it be? If he thought I'd been bad at my PQRP. Yes, the ultimate station. How could I deserve this? Could be all those weekends at work public service. He set it all up, and in record time, quickly worked 100 countries, all down on 160. I should have been happy. It was my call, he said. But the cards and the postage will cost a month's rent. He made final adjustments and left a card by the key to Gary from Santa Claus, 73. Then he grabbed his HT, looked me straight in the eye, punched a code on the pad, and was gone. No goodbye. I ran back to the station, and the pileup was big, but a card from St. Nick will be worth my new rig. Oh, too late, for his final came over the air. It was copied all over. It was heard everywhere. The ham Santa exclaimed what an old ham expects. Merry Christmas to all, and to all, good DX. And Merry Christmas from my lovely wife, Cindy.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
And Merry Christmas from me, too.
I'm Katie4ACW.
And I'm KN4AQ.
Over.
And out. Should have gotten you that Santa hat.